Benjamin Netanyahu's decade of dominance is over. He had 12 uninterrupted years as prime minister. Like him or hate him, it is difficult to overlook his influence on Israel. He was a cheerleader, a spokesman, and a war hero for his country. So Netanyahu's exit was never going to be a simple affair. Sunday was his last day as prime minister. The Israeli parliament convened to vote on the new government. Netanyahu sat through the entire proceeding. He had a deep, pensive look on his face. But around him, things descended into chaos. The new prime minister, Naftali Bennett, was heckled throughout his speech. There was a lot of name-calling and cursing. In the end, the coalition won the vote, although barely. They managed to get 60 votes. The opposition got 59. The Israeli parliament, called the Knesset, has 120 seats. So with 60 votes, the government has made it by the skin of their teeth. Netanyahu was watching all of this unfold. He got up from his seat, he shook hands with Bennett and joined the opposition ranks. And with that, Israel's longest-serving leader was out of power. He's not planning on retirement, though. At 71 years of age, Benjamin Netanyahu believes he still has some politics left in him. He plans to continue leading the Likud party.
I have a message. I have a message to those who are joyful in Tehran and to those who do as they say in Hezbollah and in Hamas. The opposition in Israel will have a loud and clear voice, and I have another message for them, just as important.
We'll be back soon. We'll be back.
But Netanyahu may or may not stage a comeback, but as younger leaders take center stage, one thing is clear: the era of Netanyahu is over. Even if he returns to power, he may not be the towering firebrand leader he once was. So it's time to look back at his legacy, his complicated and polarizing legacy. Netanyahu first came to power in 1996. His campaign was built on rubbishing the Oslo Accords with Palestine. But the weight of office soon took over. Not only did he meet Palestinian leader Yasser Arafat, he signed multiple deals with him. And this angered his nationalist voter base, and they ousted him after 3 years. Netanyahu's second stint as prime minister came in the year 2009. He presided over three flare-ups in Gaza: the 2014 war, the 2018 violence, and the 11-day conflict this year. During all these three flare-ups, he was accused of war crimes, but it made him more popular among his voters. Netanyahu's biggest impact has been the Arab-Israeli peace deals, what is called the Abraham Accords. Four Arab nations recognized Israel in 2020, the UAE, Morocco, the Sudan and Bahrain. It was a diplomatic coup for Netanyahu, and he had Donald Trump to thank for this success. Here's another legacy of Benjamin Netanyahu, a partisan relationship with the United States. In 2012, he courted then-presidential candidate, Republican presidential candidate Mitt Romney. This was during peak campaign season. In 2015, he went around President Obama's back and addressed the U.S. Congress. Why? Because he was unhappy with the Iran nuclear deal. The trend is clear. Netanyahu would much rather deal with the Republicans in America. The new government realizes this. Foreign Minister Yair Lapid talked about dealing with quote-unquote angry Democrats in the U.S. Netanyahu chose to ignore him. Bennett is seeking to engage with them. So what does he bring to the table? Well, Bennett is more hawkish than Netanyahu on Palestine. He says there was never a Palestinian state. Hence, there is no Israeli occupation. If Netanyahu is far right, Bennett takes it to a whole new level. He has publicly boasted about killing Arabs. In 2018, he advocated a shoot-to-kill policy for children breaching the Gaza border. They were terrorists, he said, not children. So blocking a Palestinian state is his life goal, some say. Does this mean that he will annex the entire West Bank? But right now it seems unlikely. Bennett has a wafer-thin majority. His partners are soft on Palestine. So he will most likely toe the Netanyahu line, manage the conflict with no intention of solving it. What about his approach to India? Well, Netanyahu proved to be a key ally for New Delhi. Under him, India's West Asia policy was dehyphenated, which meant that relations with Israel and Palestine were separated. They would stand on their own merit. This will likely continue under Bennett. Prime Minister Modi has already congratulated the new Prime Minister of Israel. Bennett responded with a message of his own. Both leaders talked about deepening the bilateral relationship. So don't expect radical changes in foreign policy. The big difference, though, is on domestic politics. Bennett has a broad alliance behind him, including an Arab party. He's talking about healing the Israeli society, reducing the rift between Jews and Arabs, the hardliners and the secularists.
We are at the start of new days. Hardships, it's not an exaggerated word in this case, but the hardships of establishing the unity government are behind us. And now the people of Israel, every single one, is putting their eyes on us and the burden of proof is on us. We will work together in partnership and with responsibility in order to mend the rift in the nation and immediately bring back the country to normal functioning after a long period of paralysis and quarrels.
This is something Netanyahu never really tried to do. He was happy consolidating his own vote bank. That vote bank still supports him. They still see Netanyahu as their leader. So Bennett has big shoes to fill. He was once considered a protege of Netanyahu. He even served as his chief of staff. There's a sense of respect between the two men. For instance, Bennett does not believe the corruption charges against the former prime minister, now Benjamin Netanyahu. For him, this is about a change of guard, not a change of ideology. And that's the issue that Israel will have to reckon with. Much like Trumpism in the US, Netanyahu's brand of politics remains hugely popular, whether he's prime minister or not. For the next few years, he will be breathing down the coalition's neck. WeOn is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.